Welcome back, folks. This is Tommy, helpwithgadgets.edc, and we've got a review to do this evening. And this was one that I kind of had mixed feelings about. In one vein, I do like the knife. It does some things very well. The front flipper is very well executed. It opens and closes very well. The reverse flick works pretty good. You have to kind of get your hand up, or at least in my case, I have to kind of get my middle finger up to be able to flick it out. I like that it has a finger choil. It's kind of a one of the simpler versions of the Alemic whippersnapper. But there's other things that I don't like as well. I don't like this huge opening for a lanyard. And after a few days of carrying it, I haven't carried it in weeks now. I did carry it and use it as I do any knife that I have, and I think that's the really the only way to make sure that you like a knife is to carry it and use it. It's hard to make, in my opinion, it's hard to make an informed decision about a knife if you just flick it open a couple of times and then do a review on it. That's not the way to do it. But like I say, it does a lot of things very well. This front flipper is one of the best actions on a front flipper of any knife that I have experienced. The clip works very well. There's just a lot of good things about it. But as I mentioned, I carried it for a few weeks, a few days, maybe the first week that I had it, and then it's sat on the counter in my little office or room here that I use to do the reviews, videos. So let's go ahead and do some size comparisons. I will show you some of the knives that we can compare sizes to. That is the EMP EDC Nimble, and then we have the Asher Knives Spiro. All right, get those out of the way. Let's go next with a Beg Knives Mini Glimpse. And we'll go ahead and pull up the other Beg Knives Bodega. This is the Steelcraft series, if I'm not mistaken, on both of those. All right, let's look at the American Blade Works model. Don't see the model one here. That may be in the other room. But here's the model two. We'll go ahead and do a Holt haptic with that. So you can tell the knife is kind of on the smaller side. Not small, I wouldn't say. This is the Artisan Cutlery Tylos and the Kaiser Knives October. All right, let's see what else we have here. Let's go with the Migueron Morial and the Migueron Carex. Two good knives that are on the budget range. Let's go with the Giant Mouse Ace Tribeca and a Kaiser Sparrow. There's a couple of size comparisons there. Let's go next with the CJRB Pyrite and the CJRB Echo. right, two button locks. One of them is a front flipper. The other is just the opening hole. Let's go with a TS, Tucson TS 380, and go with the Sharp by Design Mini Tempest. All right, and let's see what else we have here. Let's go with the Artie Blades Spectre and the Arno Bernard Amamba. And let's go with a Microtech MSI. And let's see what else we want to do here. Let's do the Mini Beluga Petrified Fish. All right. And we'll do a new to the channel, Oz Roosevelt. And a Kaiser Cyberblade. And as you can tell, the Olamic Whippersnapper is longer than the Kaiser Cyberblade, as most knives are, at least the ones in my collection. All right, so that's got that. Let's go ahead and actually look at a measurement, or a few measurements. The cutting edge on the knife is about a little bit more than 2 1/4 inches. The blade to the handle is less than 3 inches, I would say, depending on where you measure the knife. But as I'm measuring it there, it's right at about 2 3/4. The entire knife length is less than 7 inches. Again, not a big knife. But it's not a lightweight knife either. There's a large chunk of copper there in the scale. And as you can see, that it does stand proud of the scale just a little bit. As I mentioned, there's some pretty neat features. This particular knife has, I believe it's called a floating backspacer. You can see through the backspacer. Let's see if I can get something here that might help this. You can see through the backspacer that it stands off of the scales just a tiny bit. And so you can see down between there. So it shows you that if there's a high level of machining there. This is 20 CV on the blade steel. And it's just, it is a well done knife, but it's not one that I think will continue to stay in the collection. In fact, I'm pretty sure that I'm going to move this one on. But I mean, it's hard to say anything bad about the knife itself. I don't like the opening for the lanyard hole, but other than that, I mean, there's nothing really bad to say about the knife. It's just some knives don't fit well with your collection, I guess. Again, I know I'm kind of beating around the bush with not saying a whole lot, but there can be, you know, extenuating circumstances that cause you not to like a knife, or it can be just a knife that doesn't fit in with it may not be the knife you reach for when you reach for a knife to put in your pocket. And that's the case here. It's not a knife that I've put in my pocket. As I mentioned, I've had it several weeks now, and it's just not one that I carry. But there you have it. That's a little bit of a review of the Whippersnapper by Olamic. And That's pretty much it. Hope y'all have a wonderful rest of your day. If you have not done so, please like, subscribe, make comments, all that good stuff. I really appreciate those that have subscribed, those that make comments, and hope y'all have a wonderful rest of your day. Thanks.